Hello, welcome to the Living Jesus Devotionals, another day with you. It's just great. Thanks for inviting us into your homes or wherever you may be. Joy and I have been kind of walking through John chapters 18 and 19, which is the story of Jesus' arrest and crucifixion. Joy's going to be starting off today with reading verses 1 through 7 of chapter 19.
Now I'm reading from the New Living Translation. Then Pilate had Jesus flogged with lead with a lead-tipped whip. The soldiers wove a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they put a purple robe on him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they mocked as they slapped him across the face. Pilate went outside again and said to the people, "I'm going to bring him out to you now, but understand clearly that I find him not guilty." Then Jesus came out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe, and Pilate said, "Look, here is the man." When they saw him, the leading priests and temple guards began shouting, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" "Take him yourselves and crucify him," Pilate said. "I find him not guilty." The Jewish leaders replied, "By our law, he ought to die because he called himself the Son of God."
Thanks, honey. And here's my perspective on our respective worlds. Yours is a bit different than mine.
Sure,
my world has mainly been the world of the church. Think of being a dad and sometimes a single dad. But in the church where most people believe in Jesus, we talk about God all the time. And when it gets frustrating, those are the times when we forget to do things like pray, seek God's counsel on something, follow his word, you know, things like that.
Okay, well, and my world, I guess, has been professionally in banking for a very long time, but a wife and mother and now a grandmother. Mm-hmm. And those are the things that I cherish most about my world. But I'm wondering, why did how'd you come up with that during this passage? How does that relate? I'm not seeing the connection.
Okay. Right. Like to throw you a curve right now. Well, I think like Pilate says, for both of our worlds, whatever that may be, Jesus is the man.
Mm-hmm.
The living, loving, bruised, and bleeding God. That's kind of how N.T. Wright put it. But in both worlds, yours, mine, yours watching us, you know, we can easily get sidetracked from all that. And I don't think that in your world or in any world, it's easy to follow Jesus.
Yeah, I think maybe it doesn't come natural. I think you really have to be intentional to kind of inject our faith in those worlds. You know, I think of the business environment, being in banking, and there are chances to do that. You know, it's okay to talk with people about faith and to pray with them at the right time and everything. Even being a mom and a wife and all of that, sometimes it is difficult, but we can be intentional about it.
Yeah, it's pretty tough being married to me, I know. and in my world, even though it's the church predominantly, it's not as easy as some people think it is. You know, we still get our agendas, egos, our preferences in the way. You know, there's business sides of the church that still have to run, and those don't look especially spiritual all the time.
Sure.
You know, managing personalities, managing through personalities, just like any kind of organization.
Well, and emotions. Tough. And
you got emotions in the way. And, you know, and with all of that, we still need reminders that Jesus is the head of the church. And that he'll work through all of our weaknesses. It's not just when we're perfect and doing everything just spectacular and firing all cylinders just well. It's in our weaknesses, actually, that he becomes more glorified.
Yeah, and in both of our worlds and everyone's sphere and world, we need to make it all about being God's people, his people in this world, his witnesses, and sharing with everyone that Jesus really is who he says he is. He is the man.
He is the man.
And we do that with our actions, with our words, by offering to pray with people, as I mentioned earlier, by treating people honestly and above board, by not bending the rules and fudging here and there, and just being humble like Jesus was through his whole crucifixion, through his whole life and even and through this crucifixion that we're reading about.
And I have to say, sorry for interrupting you, but I have to say, honey, that, you know, through this pandemic time, we've been locked in the house together. You know, we've gotten out, but I'm working.
We're working next to each other.
And it's been great to see how you have merged those two worlds very well.
Well, thank you.
You know, I think I listened to a lot of your phone calls now, and just amazed how you just kind of navigate as a woman of faith, kind of those places. I think people could learn a lot from you, actually. So
it's been
good to see you.
Thank you.
Shall we pray?
Sure.
Okay. Do you want to pray?
Sure. Okay. Dear Jesus, we love you, and just like Pilate testified, you know, you are the man, and you are truth. You're the perfect man, and you are God in human form, in flesh, and you were humble and broken and vulnerable, and yet you're strong and victorious and powerful, and you have all authority within your hands. Thank you so much that no matter what's going on in our lives, you are here with us, and you are the man. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thanks for joining us today. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And until then, have a blessed day. Bye-bye.